All right, so I want to do a quick video on this. I just got this today. This is the Ad Motor. It's one of their newer e-bikes, and this thing is badass. I didn't know what to expect when I bought it. This is a newer product, so there's not a whole lot of customer reviews on it out there yet, but super impressed so far. I haven't really, you know, put it to the test yet, but the craftsmanship, the quality of all the components, I mean, everything is just extremely well built. And all week long I was sort of thinking that I was going to regret my purchase once I saw it, but absolutely not. It's quality. I'll just do a real quick walkthrough on some of the components, but the motor is Bafang, and they are, you know, it is a China made product. I mean, I think pretty much everything nowadays is when it comes to this stuff, but this motor has a good reputation. The company has a good reputation. They make good products. It's Shimano equipped. Everything on the gears is Shimano. It's got disc brakes on the back and the front. The wheels are slotted, as you can see. Kenda tires. These are the Juggernaut Sports, which are, again, they're a really good tire. It's not, you know, it's not the highest, but it is not a cheap tire at the same time. You've got front, you got a headlight, and you got a tail light. And this is not just a tail light, this is also a brake light, which is pretty cool. Seat is really comfortable. Again, not a cheap, it's not a low-end seat. The battery is integrated into the frame. And that really was my main reason for purchasing this bike, is I like the frame. This is a solid frame, one piece. All of the, you can see in here, all of the welds are really clean, good welds. That's one thing that you definitely want to look at on a frame, like, you know, a lot of these e-bike frames, is look at your welds, and this is solid. This is a real solid material. The finish is really nice. It's a flat, sort of a matte black finish. And I wasn't sure if I was gonna regret picking this color as well, because, you know, I think with a gloss finish, sometimes there's, you know, some room there to sort of wax out any kind of scratches and whatnot. But I like the matte finish. I think it's a good look. You know, I don't know if how it would hold up. Gloss may be a little bit more durable, but this is a good look. This is a Bluetooth speaker that I added. They do give you the toolkit. The bike toolkit comes with it. Everything up here is pretty nice. This is a twist throttle. You got your brake puller, of course. This is the Quick Fryer Shimano 7-speed. I added the smartphone holder, but LCD display, pretty standard. That's your control for the display. And then another brake puller over here, and there's a little bell, which sounds pretty ridiculous, but it's there. Again, integrated battery, which is really nice. There's a key. It's controlled on and off with a key here. The battery is 48 volts. It's a Samsung cell, and I think it's rated at 11 amp hours. And this light on the front is, of course, as you can see, LED, and it's bright. And the lights are controlled up top. You can turn it on through the LCD display, has control over the lights. And again, disc brakes on the front. Kickstand. not a real big fan of kickstands, but with a bike like this, you really almost need it. It's a larger bike. I don't know if you can really get the idea of the scale of this thing, but it is it's a huge bike. I don't know what the overall measurements are, but it's massive. It really feels more like a motorcycle or a dirt bike. But, you know, I mean, some people may not like that. It may be too much, you know, if you're going to be hauling a bike around a lot or whatever in the back of a car. But, you know, for me, I really viewed this as more of another piece of transportation. So I sort of like the scale being larger. I think also being out on the roadways, you're more visible too, which was another reason I went with the orange wheels. I'm not normally a big fan of the painted wheels like that. I normally just tend to keep it black finish or stainless steel, but I think the orange really pops, and again, it just kind of makes you a little bit more visible. So anyway, I'm super impressed so far. It's only been half a day. I've only got, I think, 3 miles on it, so I haven't had a chance to really put it to the test yet, but I'll try to upload another video this weekend with the outcome of that, just to kind of test the battery and the overall ride. One of my main reasons for, besides the frame, for purchasing the bike is the suspension and the fat tires. You know, with an e-bike, when you're moving 20 to 30 miles per hour, you know, on a standard mountain bike, if you hit, you know, even a small pothole at that kind of speed, it's gonna scare the shit out of you, and you're gonna feel it, and you may pop a tire, you could certainly wipe out. And if you wipe out on a bike doing even 20, 25 miles per hour, I mean, that's a bad day for sure. So with this bike, with the large tires, the fat tires, the suspension up front here, the shock here, which is adjustable, you can set the ride there as well. You know, with a bike like this, then you feel like, you know, you're not as intimidated by traveling on an open road and hitting bumps moving at a higher rate of speed. So that was another key decision, I guess, in purchasing. Purchase price on this is going to range, but if you buy this through eBay, you're going to spend probably $1,900. If you go straight through the manufacturer, you can probably cut that cost by 200, maybe 250, but in general, roughly $1,500. And you know, it is a lot for it's still classed as a bike, so you know, $1,500 for a bicycle for a lot of folks seems like a ridiculous amount of money to spend. But it really, you know, again, it feels more like a hybrid, you know, moped / bicycle. And I mean, depending on where you live, I mean, this can be almost your daily transportation. And I mean, they're definitely a lot more popular, you know, now than they were even 10 years ago. And especially you see a lot of these around coastal communities. But I mean, you can view it as your, you know, if you're in a small town, this can be transportation to or from work or wherever. And you don't have to, in most states, you don't have to register these. They don't have to be insured. Doesn't require any additional licensing. The operating cost is super low. I mean, to charge these up, you know, there's practically no cost associated. So, you know, you foot the bill up front, and then you figure, over time, you know, you can definitely save a lot by getting around on one of these versus a car. But you know, again, it just depends on where you live. If you're not in a small you know, sort of interconnected community or whatever, I mean, then, you know, getting around on a bike's not going to be that practical, but in a lot of areas, I think it definitely makes sense. For now, until the government starts getting their hands on these, on the profits from these as well, I think they'll eventually be taxed, I'm sure. Yes, I'm following myself around with an extension cord. My phone keeps going dead here. But anyways, all right, well, I'll follow up with another video on this in a week or so and just kind of let everybody know how things are going. But so far, super impressed. This is AdMotor, and I will put a link in the description. All right, thank you for watching.